Today, we're going to learn the best way to export Affinity Designer files for Adobe Illustrator. Right from the start, we need to be clear that Affinity Designer does not have an option to export as an Adobe Illustrator file. As nice as that would be, the AI file type is owned by Adobe, and unless they decide to license it to Affinity Designer, we'll never have this option. But as we all know, there's still times when someone in the Adobe ecosystem wants to continue working on something we started in Affinity Designer. In that case, what's the best way to export your work from Affinity Designer so they can access it in Illustrator? To answer this question, I ran a simple test. I took 7 different Affinity Designer files and then tried 5 different methods for transferring each one of them to Illustrator. I tried opening the Affinity Designer files directly from Illustrator. I tried exporting the files as PDFs, SVGs, and EPS. And finally, I tried copying and pasting all of the layers in my Affinity Designer files into an Illustrator file. With all my layers in Illustrator, I could then export the design as an AI file. For my test files, I used a wide range of designs. I tried transferring a file with a single shape, shapes layered on top of each other, a text box, a circle with layer effects applied to it, a simple vector lion, a more complex starry night scene, and an elaborate monster face design. I'll share my test results with you, and at the end of the video, I'll give you my final recommendations for how you should export your work. The first test I ran was the easiest to rule out. Illustrator can't even open Affinity Designer files, so don't bother sending them to a client. The next 4 tests were much more interesting though, with each export type working better under certain situations. For the simplest file, the object transferred perfectly with all 4 methods. The file with multiple shape layers also worked perfectly for all 4 methods, except EPS put all of the layers inside of a group, and SVG put each layer inside of a group, both of which would be slightly annoying to whoever you're sending the file to. For the file with text, PDF and copy and pasting were the best methods to use, with their only problem being the line break in the text split the text box into 2. SVG also split the 2 lines into 2 text boxes, but then it also split each letter and world into its own text box. EPS was the worst of all, because it converted each letter to curves, getting rid of the text boxes completely. For the next test file, which was a circle with a few layer effects applied to it, all 4 methods failed. Each method rasterized the circle because it had layer effects applied to it. So the effects were no longer editable, and the shape was no longer a vector. Also, PDF and copy and paste both made strange clipping groups and paths. SVG and EPS at least kept the layers panel fairly clean. With the lion test, each method had different results. 3 of the methods changed the stroke thickness of my layers, with PDF being the only one to maintain the thickness of my strokes. However, PDF had problems of its own. It got rid of all of the groups I'd made in the original file, and separated the fill and stroke of some of the objects. Copying and pasting had the exact same results as PDF. EPS got rid of my groups, but at least it didn't separate my object's fill and strokes. For this round, SVG did the best because it kept the original groups and kept the fills and strokes together. Its only error was changing the stroke thicknesses. The other problem I discovered from this round was how variable thickness is exported. While making the lion in Affinity Designer, I made each whisker with just 2 nodes and then use the stroke panel's pressure option to give the strokes a variable width. However, once this file was exported and opened in Illustrator, the variable thicknesses were converted into hundreds of individual nodes. For the Starry Night test, exporting for Illustrator did not work very well. For all the methods, any layer with a gradient or layer effect was rasterized. Also, most of the methods lost my original groups and created random clipping groups. PDF and copy and paste also separated some layers' fills and strokes. I had also made an HSL adjustment layer in Affinity Designer, but this disappeared when the file was opened in Illustrator, since Illustrator does not have adjustment layers. Fortunately, the color shift that this adjustment layer produced in Designer was carried over in the export. For this round, SVG was the winner. It maintained my original groups, did not create clipping groups, and did not separate fills and strokes. The only weird thing with SVG was that it put each layer in a group, even when that layer was already in a group, so it ended up creating groups inside of groups. For the final test, I tried exporting my monster face design. Unfortunately, all of the export methods did terribly. Because this design has so many gradients and layer effects, no export option worked even remotely well. None of the exported versions would be usable for someone in Illustrator. So, after all of these tests, what are the conclusions? Conclusion number one, unless you keep your design very simple, it will usually have trouble when you transfer it from Designer to Illustrator. So, if your coworkers or clients need to receive AI files, your best bet is to use Illustrator. I know that's frustrating, but it's the sad truth. Conclusion number two. If you made something in Affinity Designer and need to send the file to someone that uses Illustrator, your best bet is to send them a PDF and SVG. These two file types perform differently in each situation, but each had their own strengths and weaknesses. By sending both file types, you'll give your coworker or client more flexibility in choosing which file type works best for whatever they need to do. Those are my results, but please share any tips you have in the comments below. I'm sure others would appreciate it. Thanks for watching, my friends, and I'll see you in the next Affinity Revolution tutorial.